Welcome to Sport Classics. November the 5th, 1980 was the appropriate date for the fireworks provided in this meeting of two British clubs in the European Cup. Gordon Strachan and his Aberdeen teammates were at Anfield to play Liverpool in the second leg of their second round tie. Liverpool already had a 1-0 lead from the first leg.
Liverpool have lost the toss and Aberdeen have set them to attack the clock goal in the first half. Both teams normally wear red. Tonight it's Aberdeen's turn to change and they're all in white. Champions of England against the champions of Scotland. Place in the last eight of the European Cup at stake. Dalglish, Johnson, chance to shoot never appeared, and Dornan shepherds the ball over the line for a corner. Game that began with a real Anfield roar. Ground not full, but certainly full of atmosphere. Corner swung out towards Hansen's head, and a chance for Aberdeen to get away from their own penalty area for virtually the first time. That's Bell. It's an Aberdeen throw. It's Doug Rugby, who is something of a long throw specialist. Didn't need it there. Goalkeeper Jim Leighton, 6'1". Rugby. Lee challenged by Scanlon. And tripping Scanlon. Kick quickly taken again by Liverpool. Johnson tripped by Rugby. And the game is all stop-start at the moment. Malicious, but a lot of trips and nudges and pushes, and the referee determined that the players are going to know who's boss. Dermot shielding it, Thompson, and Kennedy's shot turned over well. Jim Leighton had it in his sights and flicked it over as it came. McDermott plays it in low. Dalglish turns it out. Thompson helps it on. And then Alan Kennedy is waiting to wallop it with his left foot. And it's a good save from Leighton. Rugby. Was better control then by McGee. Did that well. And slips Thompson well too. And keeps going. Neil ran right across him. And it was Clements to the rescue of Liverpool. After the back four had left him quite unnecessarily exposed. McGee started his run somewhere on the halfway line, slipped Thompson, and just keeps going. And he really ought not to get through here. But Neil didn't make the touch that was needed, and McGee's shot well fielded by Clements. Cohen, Harvey Cohen stripping off, so we're going to have a Liverpool substitution any moment. Colin Irwin was also out on the track there warming up just now. That's offside. The fact that Cohen is the player being stripped off suggests that maybe Alan Kennedy, who seems anyway to be holding the back of his thigh, maybe in a little bit of trouble. And that is exactly the substitution that's going to be made. Well, these two have been boxing and coxing in the first team this season, winning and losing places because of injury. Cohen got in first because Kennedy was injured. Then Cohen was injured and Kennedy got his place back. Got it back indeed for the first leg in Aberdeen. Now Cohen comes on to replace Alan Kennedy. Dalglish. Instruction given. It's a long way further back than that, as Mr. Prokop is explaining to Sammy Lee. They don't have a common language. Mr. Prokop speaks German and Sammy Lee speaks Gus. Lee's free kick. It's gone right through to Johnson. Blocked by Rugby. Cohen. First touch for him. Header away by Miller. Puts it out for the corner. Once again, Alan Hansen comes to take up position in the Aberdeen goal area, just in front of the near post. Ray Kennedy also in, almost on the line. Leash to Cohen. That's the back header from Hansen, and that's an own goal, I think, by Miller. So, what Liverpool couldn't do for themselves, Aberdeen have done for them. But the congratulations rightly going to Alan Hansen for a very crafty back header that completely deceived Willie Miller, the Aberdeen skipper, into turning the ball into his own net. Cohen, Israeli international. Dornan. Very cool then, because he set off facing his own goalkeeper, I'm sure with thoughts of a back pass in mind, and suddenly found it wasn't on. Lee. Johnson. Rugby. Thompson. Dalglish is back heel, and that's got Neil in, and Neil will score. What a glorious goal that was, and once again it was the inventive mind of Kenny Dalglish that made the telling contribution. Thompson, what a lovely touch from Dalglish, and now it simply requires Neil to keep his balance in his head, and in goes the goal. All smiles from Phil Neal, and once again, Kenny Dalglish shows an ice-cool brain and a marvellous awareness of players around him. Aberdeen now need to score three times at Anfield, and in the last 12 months, only one visiting team has actually scored two goals here. That was Middlesbrough. Two nil on the night, 3-0 on aggregate, approaching half-time. Referee checking his watch, he's adding a little bit on in this first half. But not very much. Liverpool go in, leading 2-0, 3-0 on aggregate. Thanks to Phil Neal's first goal since last March and an own goal by the Aberdeen skipper, Willie Miller. 2-0 it is at half-time. Join us again in a few moments for the second half.
Two cities and a rivalry that goes to the heart of their culture. The obsession reaches fever pitch as the North East Derby heads to the black and white side.
It's just like the old days at St James's Park.
Can O'Neill endear himself even more to the Maccos? Or will it be 6 points and bragging rights to the Geordies?
Like
Newcastle Sunderland, Sunday at 11, live only on ESPN.
The Barclays Premier League on ESPN in association with Bet365.
To subscribe, go to espn.co.uk/TV.
BT winter deals are now on. Get BT Total Broadband. And unlimited UK calls anytime. For just £16 a month. And now free for 3 months. To get this deal, call 0800 200 700 or go to bt.com/winter.
Some people think that money makes the world go round. Others say it's love. Envirophone think it's a bit of both. You see, they just love recycling mobile phones. Send them yours, free post of course. They could send you money. It could be up to 150 quid, or even more. So if you're bored of your mobile, why wait for an upgrade? Get money for a new one and give some love back to the environment. Find out what your mobile's worth at envirophone.com.
With Sky Movies, you get more.
Let's go.
More brand new movies every week.
Well, thank you.
More ways to watch them.
Beautiful.
And more chances to watch them.
That's going to be one hell of a ride, Staff Sergeant.
Whenever and wherever you are, in the UK and Ireland.
And I know just where to get them.
Are you ready?
No one brings you movies like Sky Movies.
Get up to 50% off hotel getaways at daterooms.com.
In the real world, accidents do happen.
And when they happen to you, it's no laughing matter.
So if you're looking for a team you can trust to get the compensation you deserve,
call the people with the expertise and the knowledge you can rely on.
Call us now on 0845 345 4444.
Or visit injurylawyersforyou.co.uk.
Aberdeen begin the second half, now kicking towards the top goal. Huge task on their plates. This is Liverpool's 50th European game at Anfield, and they've lost only three of them to Ferencváros, Leeds and Red Star Belgrade. We have a free kick here. Dermot back to Souness, Souness on to Hansen, and Hansen's shot turned aside by Leighton. And Hansen, who came so close to scoring at the end of a 70-yard run in the first leg, came up there in support of the attack, took the pass, took his time, and was well on target to get it inside the post. 7 minutes only of the second half gone, and Liverpool now in total command. Cohen. Johnson's header, goalkeeper's ball. Fish to Rugby. Strachan. We're on by McGee. Lovely little bit of skill by Cohen. Just knocked the ball up in the air with his head turned underneath it, so he's facing the right way. Bell. McGee. And a good cross, but blocked by Thompson and cleared by Hansen. Miller, Rugby, it's a bad pass, straight to Neil's feet, Lee, under pressure, Jarvey, Dermot, Souness, that's a great ball and it was meant for Dalglish and so nearly reached him, gently eased little toe-ender from Souness that almost got Dalglish in. Len Bell puts the ball away as Aberdeen so often have in midfield. Souness, Neil, McDermott, Souness, Hansen. Hansen finds Cohen, who'd got into a good position, playing it on for Dalglish. And Dalglish stopped by McLeish. Hughes header collected by Souness. Gordon Strachan, Rigby, Jarvey, and in Cohen for Liverpool, Dalglish, McLeish, Souness, Miller for Aberdeen. An ambitious ball, Neil back to Clements. Header goes out of play. Thompson. Miller. Strachan, Jarvey, Dalglish, Dermot has made the run, pass was just touched away by Rugby, by Kennedy, Johnson gets another chance, Dornan heads away, Neil, Thompson, Souness on his heels. Strachan to McGee. Hansen gets between McGee and the ball. And that's the last McGee will see on it. Kennedy, Leash, Kennedy again, Leash had got in among them, and over goes Ray Kennedy, tripped by William. Strachan goes to line the wall up. Don't need any telling that there are all kinds of dangers here. The kick's been quickly taken to Cohen. And Cohen tries to chip the goalkeeper and hits the bar. Lee, Dalglish, that's 3-0. Well, a goal that Kenny Dalglish has earned. And a goal that was virtually scored twice. Lovely bit of work by Cohen that comes back off the bar. And some beavering away there by Lee. And there's an empty goal for Dalglish to head into. To Strachan, Rugby, nice little touch from Johnson, taking it back now from Cohen, Dermot, Souness, Dalglish, Hansen is up there, this is McDermott and he's onside, and Hansen scores! Liverpool are in that mood. It needs something very special to shut them out. And they were busy opening doors all over the place then. Everybody involved. And the appearance of Hansen, the extra man in the penalty area. It was easy for him once it had been turned across by McDermott. It's his second goal of the season. It's a good ball for Dalglish. And he gets through at that time. Jackson's header has taken the weight of it nicely for Jarvey. And then Neil stepped in to head it away as McGee tried to find himself some room. Ray Kennedy. Souness. Dermot, Ray Kennedy, and Kennedy's right foot, well saved. Dalglish got in, it's still with Liverpool. McDermott to Souness, pressure stays on. Cohen, it's a bad one. Scanlon, but Leighton there to the rescue with a good save when Liverpool looked to have the makings of number five. Tonight's attendance, 36,182, only three times this season as the gate passed 40,000 here on at Anfield this season. Miller. Cooper. Taken by Cooper himself. Strachan tried to dribble his way through, failed there as he did on a number of occasions at Aberdeen in the first leg. Watson, Scanlon, Lee for Johnson, Ray Kennedy. Two in the middle hoping for a cross, Jarvey and Strachan. He was still trying to puzzle his way through. Scanlon for a bit of enterprise from Dornan, who's going to run back onside. And the shot really had very little power at all from Miller. Hansen. Souness. Lee. Johnson. Ray Kennedy in the middle with McDermott. Liverpool have lost possession. Hewitt, one of the Aberdeen substitutes. McGee running out to meet him. Strachan calling for a long one over on this side. And the call was heard, but the pass was behind him. Cooper. Last minute of the game. A header out by Thompson as Liverpool stroll their way towards another comfortable European Cup victory. McDermott. Johnson. Strachan. Stopped by Cohen. And again. Men in the Liverpool half, which is something they haven't often contrived. They still can't cross accurately enough to threaten Clements' goal seriously. The final final whistle goes, and Liverpool are in the quarterfinal of the European Cup once again, beating Aberdeen by 4-0. One of the goals scored by Dalglish, who had a hand in virtually all the menacing moves. But a fine all-round team performance in which Aberdeen found themselves up against a side just too good for them. Final scoreline, Liverpool 4, Aberdeen 0.
A lesson in European football for Alex Ferguson's Aberdeen from a Liverpool team who'd go on to win the cup for the third time, beating Real Madrid in the final. We hope you've enjoyed our dip into the archives. Join us again for more Sport Classics.